My name is Kayla Steele, and this is an overview of the ARCS model of instructional design. The ARCS model is a motivational model of instructional design created by John Keller. John Keller's interest in motivation began when he completed his dissertation at Indiana University. Keller received his PhD in 1974 and became an assistant professor at Syracuse University, where he began consulting with government, education, and business clients about learning and instructional issues. Through this research, Keller began forming ideas about learning and motivation that led to his development and introduction of the ARCS model of motivational design in 1979. In 1985, Keller began working at Florida State University, where he continued research on the uses of his ARCS model and began using the model in his own teaching practices. Keller has received numerous awards, has published 4 books, many book chapters, and a multitude of journal articles. Through my research on the ARCS model, I found 2 studies that utilize the ARCS model in their methodology. In example 1, Reynolds, Roberts, and Hawk studied librarians who incorporated the ARCS model into their library instruction. 3 different librarians began using the ARCS model with every lesson they taught and found that the ARCS model is valuable for adding motivational elements to instruction. However, they also found that it is important to customize their instruction and motivational elements to meet the needs of each group of students. In example 2, Song and Keller looked at motivationally adaptive computer-assisted instruction that was developed in accordance with the ARCS model. They studied 66 10th graders who used 3 variances of motivational computer-assisted instruction. The results were that motivationally adaptive computer-assisted instruction can be an effective, efficient, and motivating form of instruction that may also enhance learners' continuing motivation. According to the ARCS model, 4 main conditions must be met for an individual to become and remain motivated. These 4 conditions are attention, relevance, confidence, and satisfaction. The attention condition is for getting and sustaining the learner's attention. 2 strategies for using inquiry to gain attention are using problem-solving activities and giving learners the opportunity to choose their topics or projects. Humor can be used to gain attention by adding humorous introductions, analogies, or even using play on words. Variability, participation, concreteness, and incongruity and conflict can also be used to gain attention. Next is the relevance condition. Learners need to feel that what they are learning is relevant in order to become and stay motivated. Letting students know that what they are learning is immediately applicable to their lives or applicable to their future can be very motivating. Relating to past experience, need matching, modeling, and providing choice are also ways to maintain relevance. The 3rd condition of the ARCS model is confidence. To build students' confidence, learning requirements and the criteria for evaluation should be clearly stated. Students can increase self-confidence by becoming more independent in their learning or by learning new skills in low-risk environments. Additionally, teachers can set realistic expectations, attribute effort to student success, and organize materials on an increasing level of difficulty to increase confidence. The final condition of the ARCS model is satisfaction. To increase satisfaction, teachers can schedule reinforcements, provide positive outcomes for students, or offer unexpected rewards. Also, teachers can allow for natural consequences, such as reinforcing a student's intrinsic pride, or allowing a student who has mastered a task to help others who haven't. Teachers should also avoid negative influences for obtaining performance. In my position as a data specialist, one of my main roles will be leadership of our 16 registrars. Historically, the registrars have been the least supported staff at our system. My plan for this position is to significantly increase training and support for the registrars. I would like to implement the ARCS model for their trainings. My first training with the registrars will be a master scheduling training in Infinite Campus. This training is incredibly important because of the new ESSA requirements for professional qualifications for teachers, as well as the ESSA infield reporting requirements. To gain and keep the attention of my registrars, I plan to use concreteness, giving examples of important concepts and using related anecdotes. I'll use incongruity by providing incorrect examples of building the master schedule. I'll use variability throughout my presentation, varying in my delivery, the format of instruction, and shifting the interactions during my presentation. I also use humor occasionally throughout my training sessions. To ensure that the registrars see the relevance of the training, I will build on their existing experience with managing the master schedule. I'll utilize immediate applicability and future usefulness by stating explicitly why it is important to learn to appropriately manage the master schedule both now and in the future. I'll utilize need matching by establishing trust and providing opportunities for the registrars to practice with low risk. I'll also be modeling enthusiasm throughout the entire training. I will increase registrars' confidence by clearly stating the learning requirements and expectations of the training. I will attribute their successes to their efforts. I'll improve their self-confidence by allowing them to practice in low-risk conditions and become increasingly independent on building the master schedule at their sites. I'll be there to support them always. Lastly, to ensure the registrars feel satisfaction, I'll utilize natural consequences, allowing them to master the skill of maintaining the master schedule in the realistic setting of their daily jobs. I'll also utilize positive outcomes by giving verbal praise, personal attention, and providing helpful and motivating feedback. I'll also avoid negative influences. Utilizing the ARCS model, I hope that the registrars will feel motivated throughout the training and will have continued motivation to properly maintain the master schedule once they are working on their own at their sites. In my opinion, the ARCS model is an incredibly relevant motivational instructional design method, and I look forward to using it in my own instructional practices.